Hi children, how are you all? I believe you are all keeping fine. Okay, now class 6 chapter 9 data handling. This chapter is very easy to understand, easy to score marks, better you learn it nicely, okay? Because here we don't need much formulas and very easy to deal. Okay, data handling. First of all, what is data? Data means what? Data is collection of what? Collection of anything. Collection of informations. Information about what? Information about maybe the number of students in your classrooms, or number of boys and girls in your classrooms, or number of classrooms in your school, or number of teachers in your schools, or number of houses in your village, or number of vehicles in your village. Data can be of anything. Collecting the information about anything. Or data can be rainfall of the year, or data can be a temperature of the year. Nowadays data coming, every day you are might be watching the newspaper or seeing the newspaper or reading the news from the mobile also, that corona data, right? These days, today this much number of positive or this much negative, this much people tested positive, negative, this many people have died, like all the data can be of anything. So data. So, do you understand what is the meaning of data? Data is a collection of information about infinity. There are so many ways you can collect. Okay, now, data are, another one is raw data. Raw data. What is raw data? The data which are just collected. Suppose, for example, your teacher is giving a test, or marks are collected. After correction is done, marks are, one boy got 10 marks, another boy got out of 50, another boy might be got 45 marks, another boy be 30, another may be 20, another may be 5, another may be 30, or another may be even 2, possible, right? So this is a data of marks of different students in your classrooms. They are collected by the teachers. Now this data is not arranged in any manner, whether all the pass students in one group or all the fail students in another group, or ascending the lowest mark to highest mark, or highest marks to lowest mark. No manner it is arranged. Just the data is just collected. The data which are just collected is called what data? Raw data. What data? Raw data. Clear? Okay. Now, another one is grouped data. Grouped data. Suppose, group data means what? Grouping the data is called group data. Grouping the data is called group data. How to group? Suppose you are in your classrooms, maybe around 50 students, for example. Marks or exams over, teachers start distributed the paper and you come to know your marks. Now the teacher wants to know, he wants to group which group students are good in study, which group students are okay, which is weaker, which is very weak. Like that, he wants to know the collection. Now, suppose he say, marks, whoever got marks 0 to 10, go one side. This side, go all of you go this side, 0 to 10, for example. Another one, 10 to 20, go all of you this side, 20 to 30, go that side, 30 to 40, go that side. Suppose he is doing like this. Which one? 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, it goes on like this. So all the mark means he is grouping the students, based on their marks he is grouping the students. Now those who of you have got the 0 to 10, all of you going that side. 0 to 20, all of you going this side. And one boy stood up, standing in the middle. Hey, what happened? Which group is we are belongs to? Sir, I am confused. I do not know I belongs to which group. What happened? Sir, my mark is 10. Which side to go? I'll go to which one? 0 to 10 group or 10 to 20 group? Because both side 10 is right. 0 to 10 also 10 coming. 10 to 20 also coming. So I am confused. Which side to go? So this type of data is group, under group data there are two types. This type data is called exclusive. Exclusive means 10 is not included in the in this first. This is group number 1, group number 2, group number 3. Group number 1, the upper limit, this is called which one? 0 to 10, right? 0 to 10. This is called which one? Upper limit. This is called lower limit. This is called which one? Upper limit. Sorry. This is called upper limit. This is called what? Lower limit. Okay. Now, the upper limit will not be included in that group itself. The upper limit of the marks will be the, will go to the which one? Lower limit of the next group. Do you understand? So this is called which one? Exclusive. Upper limit is not included. Another one is inclusive. Inclusive. Group data two types. Inclusive. The, here it is very clear. Whoever whoever got marks 1 to 10, go that side. 11 to 12 come this side. Sorry, 11 to 20 come this side. Next, 21 to 30, 31 to 40. So, grouping. Now, this group is very clear. There is no confusion. 1 to 10, all of will go that side. 11 to 20, all will be, no, nobody will be in the middle. So, here, inclusive means the upper limit is included in the group itself. Upper limit is included in that group itself. It will not go to the next level. Clear enough? So, this is called inclusive. 20 included here itself. So group data are divided into region, inclusive and exclusive. Okay. Next. So what you have learned? Data. What is data? Data is a collection of information about of anything that is called region. Data, raw data. Raw data means what? The data which are just collected, not arranged in any manner, whether it is ascending or descending or pass mark one side, fail mark another side, no manner it is arranged, just collected the data is called what data? Which what data? Raw data. Then group data means what? Grouping the data is called group data. One group, the group data will be divided into two groups. One is inclusive, another one is exclusive. Exclusive, upper limit. Upper limit of the one class will go to the next level, lower limit of the second class. 10 is upper limit, here coming back to lower limit. 20 is upper limit, coming back to lower limit, right? So, that is called exclusive. Inclusive means what? Upper limit is will be included in that group itself. Then it is upper inclusive. See, 10 is not repeating, right? So, this is which one? Data about raw data or group data, all those finished. Okay. Now, let us go to the exercise. Exercise 9.1. Some marks are given. First, let me write the marks, okay? Which one? 8, 1, 3, 7, 6, 5, 5, 4, 4, 2, 4, 9, 5, 3, 7, 1, 6, 5, 2, 7. 7, 3, 8, 4, 2, 8, 9, 5, 8, 6. 7, 4, 5, 6, 9, 6, 4, 4, 6, 6. Okay. Now, read the question all of you with me. In mathematics test, the following marks were obtained by 40 students. Arrange these marks in a table using tally marks. So now we are collected, this data is called what data? Raw data, right? This just collected the data, data are not arranged in any manner. Now we are going to make a tally table. Marks here, tally mark. Tally mark, then number of students. Number of Okay. Now tally marks. You have to find out one. How many students students got mark one? Yes, 1, 2. How many? 1 and 2 students, right? Yes or no? So 1. So 1. Second, yes, another 1. So 2. Only 2 students. Next 2 marks. 2 mark. How many students got 2 marks? Yes. 1, 2 marks. 2. Then 3, then only how many marks? 3 students, right? So 1, 2, 3 students. Next, which one? 4 marks. Sorry, 3 mark how many? 1, 2, then 3. So 3 also 3 marks. Now go to 4 marks. How many students got 4 marks? Yes, let's come. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 students. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, children. Listen, you cannot go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You cannot do like this. That is not a scientific method of writing. Okay? Scientific method of writing is 1, 2, 3, 4, then 5th will be crossing. Understood? 5th will be crossing. Suppose if you have some more, 5, 6, 7, then you give a little gap. Again 1, 2, 3, 4, again crossing. Again if you have some more, 1, 2, like that it goes. Okay? Now, 4 is how many? 7 students are 7 students got 4 marks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th is crossing. Then little gap 1, that is 5, 6, then 7. Next is what? 6 marks. 5 mark. 5 marks, how many? 5. Let us see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And see, 1, 6. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Little gap. 6. Next, 6th mark. 6th mark, how many students got? 6 marks. 1, yes, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 students. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 crossing, gap again 6 and 7. Next, Ujjwan, 7 mark, right? 7 marks. 7 marks, how many students? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No more, only 5. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 crossing. 5. Okay. Next is 8 marks. 8, how many? Here 1. Yes. 2, 3, 4. Only 4 students. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 only. 8 more. Now 9. 9 how many? 1, 2, sorry, 9. 1, 2, 3 students. 1, 2, 3. 9 how many? 3 students. So now come 2 students. So how many? 1, 2. So 2. How many? 3. So 3. Now how many? Again 3. How many? 5 plus 2, 7. 5 plus 1, 6. 5 plus 2, 7. How much? 5. 5. How many? 4. Next, how many? 3. Right? 2, 3, 7. 2, 3, 7. 6, 7, 5, 4, 3. Okay. Now you see. Why we are doing like this? Now it is very easy to understand how many students got what marks by looking at this. Suppose this table is not there, by looking the, this is called raw data. By looking at the raw data, we cannot come to the conclusion who got the highest mark, how many got highest mark, how many got lowest mark, how many student passed, how many student failed. We will not be able to find out, right? But now after making the table, now easily we can tell, hey, how many student got 1 marks, only 2 students. 2 mark, how many? 3 students. Those who got 5, how many? Which one? 6 students. So, easily can come to the conclusion that how many pass, how many fail, all those data easily to come to the conclusion. For this table is very important. So, that in the exam there will be one question like this sure to come. Okay. Now, below that there are some more questions are there, right? Question, there are 2 questions are there. Question number 1A tells, find how many students obtained marks equal to or more than 7. Equal or more to 7 marks. 7. Let us go to all of you. 7, 7, 7. How many? 5. 5. This equal is given, right? That means those who got 7 marks, 5 students. Then 8 mark, how many? Plus 4. Then 9, how many? 3. How many? 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 3, how much? 12 students. How many students? 12 students got marks, which one? Equal to 7 and more. Okay. That is question number A answer. Now, question number B. Question number B tells, how many student mark obtained marks? How many students obtained marks below 4? Below 4 mark, how many students? Below 4, that means 4 is not included. Okay. Up to 1, 2, 3. One question mark, 1 mark, how many students? 2 students. 2 mark, how many? 3. 3 mark, how many? Again 3. So 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 2, how many? 8 students got. 8 students got which one? Marks. Which one? Below 4 marks. Okay. This is the first question all about. Okay. Okay, children, we will time already over. We will go to the next questions in next period. Okay, see you.